Welcome to the Chapter 12 lecture on Perfect Competition and the Supply Curve. The next four chapters cover the four types of market structures firms can operate in. The market structures are perfect competition, monopoly, monopolistic competition, and oligopoly. Competitive markets and monopolies are the extremes. Monopolistically competitive and oligopoly markets are more common.
There are three main characteristics of perfect competition: many buyers and many sellers, the goods offered for sale are largely the same, and firms can freely enter or exit the market. Because of the first two characteristics, each buyer and seller is considered to be a price taker, meaning they take the market price as given and cannot influence the price. Remember the following formulas from the previous chapter: total revenue, or TR, equals price times quantity; average revenue, or AR, equals total revenue divided by quantity. Mathematically, average revenue is also equal to price. Marginal revenue, or MR, is the change in total revenue from selling one more unit. The formula for marginal revenue is the change in total revenue divided by the change in quantity. Marginal revenue equals price for a competitive firm. A competitive firm can keep increasing its output without affecting the market price. Each one unit increase in quantity causes revenue to raise by the price. Therefore, the marginal revenue equals the price. This is only true for firms in competitive markets. The goal of any firm is to maximize profits. A competitive firm needs to determine the quantity that maximizes the firm's profit. To determine this quantity, we must think at the margin. If increasing quantity by one unit causes revenue to raise by marginal revenue, then costs rise by marginal costs. If marginal revenue is less than marginal cost, then the firm should increase quantity to raise profits. If marginal revenue is less than marginal cost, then the firm should reduce quantity to raise profits. Let's look at a table of data to determine the quantity a firm should produce to maximize profit. Quantity runs from 0 to 5. Total revenue, TR, and total cost, TC, are given. I suggest pausing the lecture and solving for profit, marginal revenue, marginal cost, and the change in profit to ensure that you can do the calculations on your own. Remember, price and marginal revenue are the same for perfectly competitive firms. Since marginal revenue equals 10, the price must also equal 10. At any quantity with marginal revenue greater than marginal cost, increasing quantity will raise the profits of the firm. At any quantity with marginal revenue less than marginal cost, reducing quantity will raise the profits of the firm. In this case, the firm will maximize profits by producing 4 units. Marginal costs and the firm's decision. The profit maximizing rule is marginal revenue equals marginal costs at the profit maximizing quantity. At QA, marginal cost is less than marginal revenue, so the firm should increase quantity to maximize profit through the increased profits. At QB, marginal cost is greater than marginal revenue, so the firm should reduce quantity to increase profits. At Q1, marginal revenue equals marginal cost. By changing the quantity, the firm would produce lower profits. If the firm raises price to P2, then the profit maximizing quantity would raise to Q2. The marginal cost curve determines the firm's quantity at any price. Therefore, the marginal cost curve is the firm's supply curve. marginal cost curve is the firm's supply curve. There are going to be times in which a firm is not making profits but losses. The firm must decide whether to temporarily shut down or exit the market completely. Shutdown is a short-run decision not to produce anything because of market conditions. Exit is a long-run decision to leave the market. The key difference is if the firm shuts down in the short run, they still have to pay fixed costs. If the firm exits the market in the long run, there are zero costs. In order to decide whether to shut down or not, the firm must analyze the costs and benefits. The cost of shutting down is the loss of revenue, which is equal to total revenue, TR. The benefit of shutting down is the savings on costs, which are just the variable costs, VC, since the firm still must pay fixed costs. A firm will shut down if total revenue is less than variable costs. To simplify this, let's divide both sides by quantity. The firm's decision rule to shut down is if price is less than average variable cost. Let's look at the firm's supply curve on the diagram. The firm's short-run supply curve is the portion of the marginal cost curve above the average variable cost curve. If price is greater than average variable cost, then the firm produces a quantity where price equals marginal cost. If price is less than average variable cost, then the firm shuts down and produces zero quantity. A quick note about sunk cost. Sunk cost is a cost that has already been committed and cannot be recovered. Sunk costs are irrelevant to decisions. You must pay them regardless of your choice. Fixed costs are sunk costs. A firm must pay fixed costs whether it produces or shuts down. Therefore, fixed costs should not matter in the decision to shut down. When deciding to exit the market, the firm must also weigh costs and benefits. The cost of exiting the market is the loss of revenue, or total revenue, TR. The benefit of exiting the market is the savings on cost, or total cost, TC, since there are no fixed costs in the long run. The firm exits if total revenue is less than total cost. Again, let's simplify this by dividing both sides by quantity. The firm's decision rule is to exit the market if price is less than average total cost. Likewise, a new firm can make the decision to enter into a market. In the long run, a new firm will enter the market if it is profitable to do so, if total revenue is greater than total cost. Just as before, we divide both sides by quantity, and the firm's entry decision is to enter the market if price is greater than average total cost. The firm's long-run supply curve is the portion of the marginal cost curve above the average total cost curve. There are a few assumptions regarding market supply. One. All existing firms and potential entrants have identical costs. Two, each firm's costs do not change as other firms enter or exit the market. And three, the number of firms in the market is fixed in the short run due to fixed costs and variable in the long run due to free entry and exit. The short run market supply curve. As long as price is greater than or equal to average variable cost, each firm will produce its profit-maximizing quantity, where marginal revenue equals marginal cost. Recall from Chapter 4 that at each price, the market quantity supplied is the sum of the quantity supplied by all firms. Let's look at this on a diagram. Suppose there are 1,000 identical firms in the market. At each price, the market quantity supplied is 1,000 times the firm's quantity supplied. For example, at P1, one firm is supplying 10 units. Therefore, the market supply is 10,000. At P2, one firm is supplying 20 units. Therefore, market supply is 20,000 units. And at P3, one firm is supplying 30 units. Therefore, the market is supplying 30,000 units. In the long run, the number of firms can change due to free entry and exit. If existing firms are earning positive economic profit, new firms will enter the market and the short-run market supply curve will shift right. Price will fall, which reduces profits and slows new firms from entering into the market. If existing firms are incurring losses, some firms will exit the market and the short-run market supply curve will shift left. Price will rise, which reduces the remaining firm's losses. The long-run equilibrium for competitive markets is zero profit. The process of entry and exit causes remaining firms to earn zero economic profit. Zero economic profit occurs when price equals average total cost. Since firms produce where price equals marginal revenue, which equals marginal cost, the zero profit condition is when price equals marginal cost, which also equals average total cost. Recall that marginal cost intersects average total cost at its minimum of the average total cost curve. Therefore, in the long run, price equals the minimum of the average total cost. It might seem weird that firms do not earn economic profits in competitive markets. But remember, economic profit is revenue minus all costs, including implicit costs like opportunity costs of owner's time and energy. In the zero profit equilibrium, firms earn enough revenue to cover these costs, and accounting profit is positive. The long-run market supply curve. In the long run, the typical firm earns zero profit. Price equals the minimum of the average total cost curve. The market supply curve is horizontal at the price, which equals the minimum of the average total cost. This is the end of the Chapter 14 lecture on competitive markets. If you have any questions about the key concepts from this chapter,